Next section, brain and behavior. Different parts of the brain affect different aspects of behavior. The frontal lobe, your forehead part, is important for planning of movements, recent memory, and some aspects of emotion. The temporal lobe, bottom of brain, near and behind your ear, is important for hearing and advanced visual processing. Every behavior is determined by brain and their parts. Brain perceive stimuli from environment, internal as well as external, instruct the mind to behave. Brain is central part to manipulate biological motives which cause behavior. Brain and behavior determine the health status of individuals. Nervous system. The nervous system is composed of two major divisions. First, central nervous system, CNS. Second, peripheral nervous system, PNS. Look at this. Brain, spinal cord, central nervous system. Peripheral nervous system, look at this picture. Spinal nerves. Detail going on nervous system, divided into peripheral nervous system, central nervous system. Peripheral nervous system divided into autonomic nervous system, somatic nervous system. Central nervous system divided into brain and spinal cord. Autonomic nervous system divided into sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system. Brain divided into three important parts: forebrain, midbrain, and hindbrain. Forebrain divided into telencephalon, into cerebral cortex, basal ganglia, hippocampus, amygdala. Dencephalon, thalamus, hypothalamus. Midbrain into mesencephalon, including tectum, tegmentum. Hindbrain divided into entencephalon, myelencephalon. Mesencephalon into bones and cerebellum. Myelencephalon into medulla. Look at this picture. Nervous system control behavior. Central nervous system, the body's master control unit. Peripheral nervous system, the body links to the outside world. CNS divided into spinal cord, a column of nerves between the brain and the peripheral nervous system. Brainstem connects the brain to the spinal cord. Brain divided into three major parts: the hindbrain, lower part, the midbrain, and forebrain. Peripheral nervous system (PNS) classified into the autonomic nervous system and somatic. Autonomic nervous system regulates involuntary body processes including heart rate, respiration, digestion, and pupil contraction. Operates automatically without conscious direction. The somatic nervous system carries sensory information from sensory organs to the CNS and relays motor movement commands to muscles, controls voluntary movements. The autonomic nervous system divided into sympathetic NS, parasympathetic nervous system. The sympathetic prepares the body for action and stress. This is called fight or flight. Peripheral nervous system clamps the body and helps the body to conserve energy. Look at this CNS, central nervous system, brain and spinal cord. Peripheral nervous system, PNS. Autonomic nervous system, parasympathetic nervous system, sympathetic nervous system. Look at these colors. Light green in color, sympathetic, and rose in color is parasympathetic. Supplied to every organs in human body. Look at this, parasympathetic, sympathetic. Parasympathetic nerves supply directly from the brain to each organs. Sympathetic through spinal cord. Look at this. So every behavior determined by the nervous system knows. Sympathetic determine dilators. People inhibit flow of saliva, accelerate heartbeat, dilates bronchi in lungs, then inhibits peristalsis and secretion, conservation of glycogen to glucose. Look at this in liver. By these sympathetic nerves, then secretion of adrenaline and noradrenaline, then inhibits bladder contraction. The chain of sympathetic ganglia. So sympathetic nerves control these all the behaviors in human body and functions. Then peripheral nerves stimulates flow of saliva, slows heart beat, constricts bronchi in the lungs, stimulates peristalsis and secretion, then contracts bladder. So sympathetic and parasympathetic nerves doing vital role to control behavior of human body and control the functions of each organs. Look at this brain, parts of brain, cerebellum, cerebrum, brainstem, forebrain, midbrain, hindbrain. Detail about three parts of brain. First, cerebrum fills up most of your skull. It is involved in remembering, problem solving, thinking, feeling. It also controls movement. The cerebrum is composed of two hemispheres separated by a deep groove that houses a band of 200 million neurons called the corpus calloseum. The outer seal is called the cortex. It is extensively folded and consists of billions of neurons. Second, the cerebellum sits at the back of your head under the cerebrum. It controls coordination and balance. Look at this, some more detail about the functions of parts of brain. Medulla responds for regulating unconscious functions such as breathing and circulation. Bones involves in sleep and arousal. Cerebellum controls bodily balance. Corpus callosum, bridge of fibers, passing information between the two cerebral hemispheres. Then hypothalamus, responsible for regulating basic biological needs, hunger, thirst, temperature control. Thalamus really control for cortex, handles incoming and outcoming signals. Pituitary gland, master gland, regulates other endocrine glands. Third part of brain is brainstem. Sits beneath cerebrum in front of your cerebellum. It connects the brain to the spinal cord and controls automatic functions such as breathing, digestion, heart rate and blood pressure. Midbrain, zencephalon, structures of major importance in the midbrain includes nuclei and fiber tracts. They extend from the bones to the hypothalamus. Look at this picture, midbrain, zencephalon. Inferior colliculi superior colliculi and tectum. So clear picture about mencephalon. Got this? Responsible for the integration of various reflexes, including visual reflex. Example, automatically turning away from dangerous object when it comes into view. Auditory reflexes. Example, automatically turning toward a sound that is heard. And writing reflexes. Example, automatically keeping the head. Look at this, some more pictures. Bones, medulla, cerebrum, midbrain, cerebellum, brainstem. Detail about medulla. It contains vital centers that regulate heart rate, blood pressure, and respiration, and reflex centers for swallowing, sneezing, coughing, and vomiting. The medulla, bones, and midbrain from the structure known as the brainstem. Cerebellum. The functions of the cerebellum are concerned with involuntary movement such as muscular tones and coordination, and the maintenance of posture and equilibrium. Bones. The bones is the bulbous structure that lies between the midbrain and the medulla. It is center for respiration and skeletal muscle tone. Dencephalon. The encephalon connects the cerebrum with lower brain structure. Thalamus. The thalamus integrates all sensory inputs except smell on its way to the cortex. The thalamus also has some involvement with emotions and mood. This picture, the encephalon, hypothalamus, right thalamus and left thalamus, cerebellum. Some more detail about the encephalon, brain and brainstem. Look at this. Medulla oblongata, spinal cord, bones, hypothalamus, pineal gland. Look at this. Midbrain, thalamus, cerebral hemisphere, etc. Hypothalamus regulates the anterior and posterior lobes of the pituitary gland. It exerts control over the actions of the autonomic nervous system and regulates appetite and temperature. Lymphatic system These structures include the hippocampus, mammillary body, amygdala, olfactory tract, hypothalamus, cingulate, gyrus, spectrum, pleurisyedum, thalamus, and hornix. The lymphatic system, which is sometimes called the emotional brain, is associated with fear and anxiety, anger, aggression, love, joy, and hope, and sexuality, and social behavior. Look at this wonderful animated picture. Clearly we can see that in color. Hypothalamus, red in color. Look at this, red in color. Amygdala in green in color. Two sides of the brain, right and left. Then hippocampus, blue in color. Got this, blue in color. Bones, golden color. Got this, golden color. Then pituitary gland, pink. Where is pink? Look at this, it's pink in color. Some more pictures are available here. Hypothalamus, thalamus, hippocampus, amygdala, olfactory bulb, frontal lobe is associated, etc. It's a lymphatic system. Hypothalamus, thalamus, amygdala, hippocampus. Mencephalon. The mencephalon or afterbrain is the most posterior region of the embryonic hindbrain, from which the medulla oblongata develops. Look at this picture. A brain stem including the mesencephalon, corporata, quadrigema, cerebral, peduncle, bones, medulla oblongata, spinal cord, etc. Mesencephalon, it is the embryonic part of the hindbrain that differentiate into the bones and the cerebellum. It contains a portion of the fourth ventricle and trigeminal nerve CN5, abducens nerve CN6, facial nerve CN7, and a portion of the vestibulocochlear nerve CN8. Look at this tegmentum, tectum. Look at this picture for more visualizing. Neuromere fetus in the developed brain, telencephalon, dencephalon, mesencephalon, metencephalon, then melencephalon. mesencephalone detail going on. Look at this picture. Mesencephalone. The short part of the brain stem just above the bones. It contains the nerve pathways between the cerebral hemispheres and the medulla oblongata. As well as nuclei, relay stations of third and fourth cranial nerves, the center of visual reflexes such as moving the head and eyes is located here. Telencephalone is subdivision of the forebrain. Look at this picture. It is comprised of the cerebral cortex and hippocampus, amygdala, olfactory bulb and basal ganglia. Look at this, some more picturization, telencephalone in different colors. This encephalone, metencephalone, melencephalone, you know, looking different colors. Spinal cord, detail going on. The cylindrical bundle of nerve fibers and associated tissue which is enclosed in the spine and connects nearly all parts of the body to the brain, with which it forms the cerebral nervous system. Thank you. Have a wonderful day.